Today in the news, we get more cameras on our phones, expensive RAM, and ray tracing without ray tracing cores. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Let's get this started with Nokia. In case you didn't know, they still make phones, and their latest one has a promotional video that has been leaked. The Nokia 9 PureView takes things to another level with 5 cameras on one side. Looking at the promo video, it looks like the Zeiss system allows for extreme performance in low light, incredible textures and details, great HDR, and some great post-production capabilities. The phone has a 5.99-inch display with 2K resolution and HDR10 support. It will have a fingerprint sensor under the glass, will ship with Android Pie, and will feature Android One. In case you didn't know, Android One is kind of a double-edged sword. While the updates are more frequent and allow for you to have the latest software faster than other manufacturers, it does only have 2 years of support from Google, which means that after 2 years, if Nokia doesn't take the initiative to update your device, you'll be stuck at that OS. For a guy like me that doesn't update his phone as frequently as I used to, that could be an issue. Overall, the phone looks pretty good. No notch, good specs, but the camera system is of course to be tested. Moving on, it looks like we might have a little insight as to why we'll get so many versions of the RTX 2060. Apparently, GDDR6 memory costs 70% more than GDDR5. Sticking to the older type of memory could have add-in board partners save around $22 per card by using 6 GDDR5 chips instead of the pricier GDDR6. Now you might think $22, that's nothing, just add it to the MSRP. That's what a good-hearted, reasonable person would do, but we're talking about a corporation here. Remember how Apple adds $100 to double the memory between your iPhone models? Well, it's the same thing, and it can't cost them more than a few dollars to do so. So expect maybe a $30 to $60 premium to go from one type of memory to the next. Then we have ray traced gaming without ray tracing cores. This isn't really new though. Ray tracing has been used for decades on modern computers, but to use it to play Battlefield 5, you do need a DXR compliant card. This card is the Titan V. Some users were able to turn RTX on a Titan V, and the performance is extremely similar to an RTX 2080 Ti. In case you didn't know, the Titan V doesn't have any ray tracing cores. It does, however, have 640 tensor cores. If we look at the 2080 Ti, it has 544 tensor cores and 68 ray tracing cores. I mean, I'm not sure what to think here. Are ray tracing cores just dedicated tensor cores? Ray tracing for Battlefield 5 was probably developed on the Titan V, so maybe it was optimized to use tensor cores, and in the future, games that support RTX might take better advantage of the whole RTX ecosystem. Honestly, it doesn't really matter until someone gets us performance numbers on ray tracing in Battlefield 5 using a 1080 Ti. I know there are demos like the Star Wars one where the 20 series eclipses the 10 series, but that was using DLSS and ray tracing at 1440p. I really don't know why EA would just remove the option to do ray tracing on the 10 series of cards. For all we know, that might make someone who has a 1080 Ti want to buy a 2080 to get better performance. Or they won't upgrade at all because the 1080 Ti would still work just fine. Now I get it. Moving on to gaming, it looks like the Xbox One will be able to play Nintendo games. Okay, I admit it, it was a little bit clickbaity to say, but the creators of Retroarch, a popular emulator for retro consoles, is committing to release a Xbox One port of their emulator. That means that you could play NES or SNES games and many other retro titles on your Xbox One. The only catch is that the Xbox Store is likely not going to let that happen. It's not that big of a deal, since for $19 you can enable dev mode on your Xbox and install all the homebrew apps you want. If I get around to turn on my Xbox One again, I might spend the money to make this happen. What about you? Let me know down below. Alright guys, that is pretty much it for the news. Hopefully you've enjoyed. Don't forget that the comment section is here, and if you've got any questions or comments, I read them all. You can click right here to see the latest video, and right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Let me put my hand right where it is, because usually it's like a little bit too much on the left. Anyways, as usual, stay frosty guys, and I'll see you on the next one.